Hey, what's going on, guys? This is just a look at the tank under white lights. I usually film and take pictures under the blue actinic lights, right? Because that's like the most visually appealing look of the tank. Until now, I never really gave white lights a chance, right? But with the colorful fish I have, I always wanted to see how they look under white lights. And by me getting a new phone, this was a great opportunity to play with the settings. I still have some adjusting to do as I record, as far as like getting the glare and all that kind of stuff out. But overall, I love the look. Especially I love the look of the fish like this dotty back. The corals do look amazing too under white light. It looks more natural. You get a good visual aspect of the corals and the fish. This is like my favorite fish right here, the spotted mandarin. But I'm actually loving the white lights. It's also giving me a chance of seeing pests or algae in the tank, because the blue lights kind of cover those, right? Even looking at this, like you can see this crab, half of his shell is covered with coralline algae. I thought that was it's a beautiful thing to look at. So I could see different things with the white lighting. So I'm enjoying myself. This tank has been through some ups and downs, mainly losing some corals and some fish, but hey, that's how it goes sometimes. It kind of shifted my thinking to, I want this tank to strictly be a soft, a fleshy coral type tank with colorful fish. The plan is to add maybe a Yasha Gobi pair. I'm kind of hesitant because of this guy. He can be aggressive towards fish of the same body type. So I don't think I'm going to do it for this tank, but maybe in the future tanks downstairs. Plan on, you know, adding some Yasha Gobies. Or I may end up moving this guy to the 200 gallon. Who knows? Because my wife really loves the Yasha Gobi. And their symbiotic relationship with the pistol shrimp. So for me, just kind of like, this year is going to be like a recalibrating new start year. And I don't know, I'm going to see how this journey takes me. As I mentioned before, I had some coral loss, and I believe it's due to two things. Nitrates and alkalinity swings. Most of all my SPS died, that's probably due to alkalinity swing and high nitrates. As you can see, I took this test, and the test kit's expired, but I just kind of want to get a handle of how much nitrates I had in the system. And I'm definitely in the 50s. That was before the water change. And now, after the water change, I feel like I even raised them, if you can believe it. So I think I'm gonna combat this in two ways. The first way will be adding marine pure spears to the back chamber of the hang on back refugium, and they'll send vibrant along with that every week, like half dosage to boost the bacteria and for the marine pure blocks to really house the bacteria and lower the nitrates. I'm also going to be doing water changes every 10 days. I'm trying to do that on par. As far as the alkalinity, which you can see here is 6.8, which is crazy. I'm just going to dose ESV out.
So I thought I got rid of my Aptasia, but I didn't. It's a bunch back here in the hang on back refugium. See right there. So I don't think I see any more. I thought I saw one on there. So I'm thinking about doing burglary back here, but it's contained, right? There's a bunch of it back here. I think I could put like one burglar in there. Look at that, ooh, they deep. And let them just chow down. Oh, it's deep back here, huh? Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do a burglar. So if Aptasia worked in my display, but in the hang on back refusion, they in there. So I'm gonna type.
Check out the size of this Astarina star I just plucked from the system. Like, this thing is huge. Usually Astarina stars are like half this size. And it's a fully, you know, five star. Like, some of them are like, you'll see two legs, you know, broke off, whatever. This thing is massive. I almost want to keep it, but I know the damage they can do. So I choose not to. But I'm going to look into getting a harlequin shrimp. And, I know I'm going to have to feed it, like, chocolate chip stars, but at least I won't have any Astarina stars. It'll take care of those. So, two pests in 1 week. What's going on, guys? This is my tank, January 25th, 2021, and I lost all of my gold torches. They used to be on this like arch, and they're all gone because of high nitrates and alkalinity swings. My alkalinity dropped down to 6. It was at like 8, so, and I blame that due to this. Was turned off, so that sucks. So I gotta tune that back in, but it got me thinking, how do I want to handle this tank? Do I want it to be like all softies, you know, a little bit LPS, like a lot of fleshy stuff? So I'm still debating that, because I do have the new tank, and like I have more bells and whistles on that tank to make it easier. So we'll see. I may just try to get this back on track. I did a water change, and I also added some Kimi Pure Blue in the back. So flow kickback, though. I just fed the tank. This guy's doing wonderful. I got this from a local fish dealer, Duke Ocean Gardens Reef. This is a cleaner wrasse, different type, doing wonderful. As far as fish, I know last time I had like the rainforest gobies. Haven't seen them in a while. They don't really do well. And I had another type of like fairy wrasse that didn't make it. So everybody else is doing good. Look at that, guys, out. Look at that. Wow. See if I can get a better shot. The light off. Look at that guy. He's out and about. Make a good picture. Clean shrimp still doing good. Clowns still doing wonderful. The damsel, what is that called? The spring-eyed damsel. Still doing good. This torch recedes and come back. But I don't know. You know what I mean? I'm gonna try to get that one out so I can't put in the mini tank. Blue hippo tank is doing absolutely amazing. No problems there. This sunset dotty bat is one of my favorite fish. I'm gonna say one because that guy is my favorite fish. That's my spotted mandarin. But like I said, overall, tank is not doing bad other than the gold torches checking out on me. Just the life of a nano, right? So, I'm going on vacation in the next, for this week. So the wife is gonna be charged to feed the tank. I'm gonna fill the ATO up, so there's plenty of water in there. And I'm gonna do another water change on Saturday. So, more to come.